big day has finally arrived. It's the coach who will wear the crown as a Super Bowl champion of the Madden Ultimate Team Playoffs. Coming up, we've got a good one on tap between the Orlando Orbits and the Dallas Cowboys. So with that, let's head over to the heart of Texas. Massive
solo
AT&T
battle time.
Stadium
if you're here,
in Arlington.
Come on by
on
and say hello.
Here
say hi
Brandon
to the
Godden
chat.
And Charles Davis.
You're here. And you can watch me.
Brandon
totally
Godden, Charles Davis with you from
battles.
Our broadcast perch. And Charles, as we get this thing started, what are you going to be keeping your eye on?
Special teams. Field position is always a big determiner in a ball game. Who sets their offense up for success the best? That team will win the game.
This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And they'll be led out by the former 6th-round pick out of UAB, Joe Webb.
Undercrush.
They begin with a run by Smith. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on
the
edge.
Let's go.
A first carry for the converted wideout, J.D. McKissick. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
All day, I'm here all day.
That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
In any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
And an alley to run. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. Decent gain on the scramble to 6, but now it's 4.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
On 4th down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away.
My moderator's here to kick people out.
And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the 5. They spot it at the 6-yard line. Here's the Dallas offense now, heading back out onto the field. They've shown very little offensively to this point. Well, neither team has, really. They come up here now, 1st down.
Switch up.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 14 yards, good for a Cowboy first down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Just despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
On second down, Elliott. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Von Bell up to make the tackle.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on the run and shut them down.
Mayfield looks to throw, and quickly to his tight end, Clark. That's caught. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. That'll be enough to keep the drive moving forward. Another first down on the pickup of 5 yards. And on third down, Dallas Clark, he's a bread and butter guy, and he shows you why there.
I've always liked bread and butter.
Who doesn't like bread and butter?
That's why I love that description.
Yeah.
I love that description, though, because that's what you want to go to, right? Something that feels good, makes plays for you. Dallas Clark did that all the time. Didn't matter the situation.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
We need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
A first down there on a pickup of 25.
There's so many things to watch for when you play defense.
Let him know.
And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? They sprang the big one, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Running game's played a huge part in getting them down to this point on the field. I say stay with it. Keep pounding the football. Keep driving. Keep grinding.
Yeah, even down in the red zone, keep going. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. 9 yards on the touchdown run. And the Cowboys are in for six. That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts your defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Now this offense about ready to take over again. And looking at this situation, Charles, you got more than a minute. You've got all three timeouts. Probably no need to play this safe.
So what you're saying is that we're doing a little bit of a mind meld here, aren't we? Because I'm thinking along the same lines as you. This amount of time, don't be compelled to play it too safe. This is a chance to get points on the board. Press it a little bit.
And especially since a touchdown here gets you the lead.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the...
Fuck!
It was time to make a break for it.
Ouch.
Mike, 44. Let's go, defense. Hey, man up, D.
Now a first down throw. Webb. Now they go screen. It's complete. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
To throw, Webb. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Good coverage that time by Patrick Robinson. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because incompletions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Give them a couple on the run as it brings up the fourth down.
How about the fellas with the stars on the side of their helmets rising up on defense? We always hear about the Cowboys rushing offense. Their rush defense is pretty good as well. I think because they're so cohesive.
Is that better? How about now, Patrick?
Really work well together.
Here's Brian Anger.
Is that better?
Now,
I raised the volume. Things are peaking. It's better, he says. How about now? Now we're looking studly. We've got 14 seconds left. I think I can score a touchdown in 14 seconds.
Left to this first half as they come up on first down.
You're not ready.
It's the same. Off the play fake. Wide open, that's Clark. They lost him. And mark him down way up close to the 40.
Okay, bye Jedi Smash.
And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
If anyone's here, come say hello. Say hello in the chat.
Final play of the half, Mayfield. He'll let it fly in the direction again. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Who's in the chat?
So two quarters down,
I cannot see you in the chat. Come and make fun of me.
All right, Brandon, thanks
for my
very
crappy
much.
Football
Welcome
play.
Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report.
Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter.
Cut that
the Cowboys
right.
Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in
Cut
quarter
right.
three. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take this from near the 25, call it the 26-yard line.
Since I have 3 viewers. If they're real viewers or not.
Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead now.
That was the sound.
To extend that lead.
Anybody with the sound?
This is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects. Tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the
come
adjustment.
On, come on,
without
come on.
Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Did he gain no yards?
In this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion and would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone,
come on, baby.
You see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Where are my peeps at?
Before when you run drag routes, you're able to hear the receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation,
my Zeke,
the defense
52.
Is effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going. Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence.
Here we
Found
go.
The hole
here we
in the
go.
Zone, made sure the quarterback saw it.
Here we go, here we go, here we go. Omaha, Omaha. Here we go, Omaha.
And inside the 45. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Cowboy first down.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. And he's taken down inside the 30.
Let's go, boys, bring it up!
Third quarter. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
Not today you are. Not today.
A first down carry by Alley. And an Alley to run. And they'll get this down to the 10. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
I think there's a fatigue factor that's
anyone here? You know the will is just me by myself?
Yeah, absolutely. It's looked that way. We'll see if they can continue this already strong drive. Now Elliott. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott. His second touchdown of the afternoon.
Can't hear me. Why can't you hear me? I turned up the volume.
And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone. They do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who are blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves sticking in the end zone on a running play.
Oh.
And
oops.
The play clock is going to run
oops.
Out here. They're in no hurry
is that better?
Play off.
Delay of game,
offense. Oh, good. Can hear me now. Woohoo. That's why nobody was talking to me before.
This certainly feels like they were wanting to go
for the 7. Crap.
Do we
means I'm going to have to throw a slant.
That's right.
Now you probably line up throw a slant.
So up comes Mayfield as his guys will go for 2. Throwing Mayfield. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So they go with a pass.
I think I gotta do it this way to make it look normal.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their 2-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how much that one, that particular play factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15.
It's gonna be a long weekend in Canada this weekend. Can't wait to play all 3 days.
Strategy now.
Just
when
sitting
I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always
here
talk about
in the
they actually
cave.
Have 2-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
Keep playing.
The situation for him offensively as follows. Down by 2 touchdowns. At time, a huge factor. They've yet to score all game long, but now they need to do so twice in short order to have a shot. Now a first down throw complete downfield. And they've got it well across.
My defense just can't cover anybody.
It's all said and done. So from
my
Cowboys
defense can't
now,
cover
first
anybody.
Right at the
watch
4.
Out.
Watch out. Out of the gun, it's Webb. Now he'll dump it.
Why do you give me a check mark to say I win when I clearly don't win?
He'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
So you cover 2 men. They're not cover 2ing or man.
And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 2.
Mm-hmm. Anyone else in the chat?
Throwing again.
I have 2 viewers. I don't know who they are though.
And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard.
Really? Did he catch that? Really? How the fuck did he catch that when there were 3 of my clowns all over him?
Here as he's taken down.
That's a big loss.
Nick Bosa.
Ooh, Nick Bosa. Nick Bosa? Oh, yeah, Nick Bosa.
To try again after the sack.
You got nothing.
Webb.
Once you get into
that's my rookie
zone,
premier card.
Have less ground to cover.
Nick Bosa.
Be quick with your delivery. Not much
I got Joey Bosa, too.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there.
Not my cat?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Webb. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
Oh my God, I got an interception.
What
the hell is that possible?
All right.
Let's see if I can rack up another touchdown.
As we're recapping it, we're talking about what offenses did and how they won the game. Let's flip this one over.
I think I'm close to level 24. They frustrated the offense. This might put me over the edge. That's why they're walking out of here with victory.
And they're going to love to walk out of here with that as their final act, that interception. Good way for them to end it.
This is pretty cool. I'm sitting here at my home. I'm playing on the PlayStation at my cottage.
Things are in sync, aren't they? Teams winning, got a nice little
100 kilometers away.
Completing some passes, and they just completed another one for a first down there to the tight end.
That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. And again, he finds Clark. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Go. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I mean, that's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange.
Google made a photo book for me of my cat. That might be worth printing.
Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Dallas Clark. Third down here. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
I'm darn right.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. A 16-yard touchdown. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over?
Oh, crap.
This certainly feels like it's over after that.
Ah!
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it?
And ah, needed that extra point. Damn it.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. This will be taken way up by the 25. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Rod Smith, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game.
If you're here, say hello. They just really haven't got. Love to know who's here.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Well, it just seems like all game long, there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
All right, they're going
to
try.
If I can stop them here, I'm able to get a field goal, get over my 21 points.
On fourth down,
for that extra. Ooh, nice.
And this is good.
For that extra XP.
They had XP. To go for it with such little time remaining.
Alright, what are we doing?
All she wrote for this.
Old reliable.
So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
They go play action here on first down. And that one drops to the ground. Incomplete. Clock stops here just inside of 20 seconds, 19 left. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise or throwing?
I have to get better before I am Steve Rogers watches me or comes play with me.
They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense can crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Pretty quiet, team. Pretty quiet.
From the red zone now, they midfield. This is caught. Clark. And he's brought down. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Mayfield keeps it himself, and they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just added their totals.
Yes. Oh, way to go. Way to go.
Not happy about this score this late. Not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings.
Exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might have. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Woo! That's what I'm talking about.
I know we could sit up here and dance around it a little bit, but going for two in this situation. Somebody doesn't like someone else. There's no doubt in my mind.
Well, what they couldn't see is you lean back in your chair and you went,
I mean, that's
not a good decision. They didn't get it, though.
Yeah, I don't think you can just say, well, my kicker's hurt in this spot.
No.
No, okay.
Hey, we got three down.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Way to get behind him, pass the run.
So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And this was truly a total team effort, Charles, on both sides of the ball.
Well, they absolutely pitched a shutout, so it can't get much better than that, right? The defense led the way. But the offense did their part as well. They moved the ball up and down the field. So you've got to like what you saw. What do they call that? A total team effort? I think when it's time to hand out game balls, guys from both sides will end up getting one.
If you're in joining, give me a shout. Say hi. Ooh. So close. I thought I'd look at that sound. Ooh, 4,000 coins. Ooh, better than the 1,000 I have been getting. All right, last one. Just doing MVP. Because I suck. Barely beat MVP. Says I got 3 viewers. If you're here, say hi. Like to know who else is here. Or am I just talking to myself? I could be just talking to myself. I do that anyways when I play. So, I am out here talking to myself. I should do that Larry Allen tonight.
Punch one of 2 tickets to the Super Bowl.
I got time.
Coach, and this is the Madden Ultimate Team Playoffs.
Sam Martin set to kick
off. Oh, crap. That's going
to
go out of bounds.
Kick it away.
No, it's not.
This will be taken very short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. They'll be led out by their quarterback who played his college ball at Western Kentucky.
Mike White.
Hilltopper.
It's Mike Cowboy. White. I don't think anyone in my chat were real. I think they're all bots.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Silver.
The play fake, now White. And this one caught by Max Williams. And all the way down to the
I have no words.
You ready?
A big play there.
I have no words for that play.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
I have no words.
What our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired up. Now a play fake here on first down.
Oh my God, I got an interception.
Picked up by Jalen Ramsey.
Go, Jalen. He could go all the way. Oh, pick six.
Spots like that prove us right.
I love the way that you spotlighted the athleticism because you and I both know the best athletes on the field, they play on defense.
Oh, I don't know. I was a kicker. You got to remember that now.
Come on.
And there's a quick momentum swing. INT return for a pick six and then the two-point conversion good.
And even if you're keeping your wits about you, you're thinking to yourself, okay, extra point block team going into the game now. All of a sudden you're hearing defense. Everyone's scrambling for their helmets and throwing down their cups of water. That's a great position for them to be in, trying to score against that team. A little bit disjointed.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10. On first down, it's White. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Anyone here?
Now the first carry for Wendell Smallwood. A solid
anyone here?
On first down.
Anyone?
Seven, leaves him
nobody?
Second and three. You often say
just two fake viewers.
Play, but now second is short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 15 yards on the play, first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Send that to Joey. Maybe he'll come join.
Let's go now.
Oh, you're still here. Why are you still here? You gotta be bored. Well, there's gonna be screaming at the computer.
On first and 10, White looking middle, and it's incomplete. The tight end, Max Williams, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down.
And that's one he's gotta be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive.
And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. Off the edge, it's Tyrone Crawford with a sack.
Wait, Tyrone! You're Canadian, dude.
Coverage was
going to be a 50-yard field goal.
Exactly as you would expect, a passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Okay.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
NFL kickers nowadays, they make things look so easy because normally from this range, about two out of three, and this is not an easy kick.
Yeah, 20 years ago, you get where he was in that 50 range, maybe a little over, and it's a big kick, but now we just, if they leave it short, you're like, whoa, what happened? And that's what we have here.
Yeah, you're right. 20 years ago, we were saying run some more plays and get closer. Now we think they're definitely within range, and you're exactly right. When it comes up short, there has to be something that went wrong because they have plenty of leg.
So Dallas Clark with a catch there, and he stands number four all-time in Colts history in receptions.
And that goes all the way back to 1953 in Baltimore. Number four.
Yep.
Two of the guys ahead of him are Hall of Famers. That's how impressive that list is that Dallas Clark is on.
Okay. Bye.
From the 30 on second down, Mayfield throwing left side. He's got Clark complete. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. One quarter down, 8-0 the score. Second quarter down, it's our home team with possession as they've got it with a first and 10.
Let's see what you got.
On first down, it's Elliott. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Now Elliott, and this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield. And
that he is into the end zone for a Cowboy
touchdown.
Touchdown,
baby. Let's go.
8 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Cowboys extend their lead.
Could not have scripted it any better. And many offenses do script their opening possession on offense. They followed that one perfectly. Took the ball right downfield and scored, giving energy not just to the offensive unit, but to their team overall.
And the conversion good. He's got it. So the lead swells to 16-0. So two successful two-point tries now for them.
And you know what it does? It gives you a boost, a huge one for your team because, hey, you're dominating them now. They can't stop you either scoring touchdowns or two-point conversions. But how about the defense? You don't know what to do at this stage. You can't stop them in any direction.
Here's Martin now following the score as he'll send this one away. And a short kick, taking it about the 16. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it out past the 30.
Let's go!
Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays.
Switch it.
Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Come on, set.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Now on second and 13, White, and able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
Watch the curl.
White looks to throw, and he will go down. A Cowboy sack. Jalen Ramsey with a sack on the corner blitz. Another try after the first down sack. White, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. To throw, White. Got a man, it's complete. Williams. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
Let's go!
Now White with a first down throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. To throw again on second down. White, this one complete to Smallwood. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Come on, baby.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. This will be their first trip to the red zone. First and 10 at the 19.
He's coming. Double up. He's coming, double.
Here's White. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
There we go.
Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. From the shotgun, here's White. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Only a yard of the completion, it's second and goal.
Is that not the very definition of a tough yard game?
Now, is that one where as the receiver you go to your quarterback and say, why'd you even throw that?
Yeah, I think you do, and I think you wonder, what type of a route are you going to send me on that only 1 yard is going to be the result? If I'm going to go in there and take contact, let's go and get something out of it, not just 1 yard.
Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a third and goal. To throw is White. Going to throw on third and goal. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
And Dawson's kick is good. And they'll at least get on the board here, still trailing, but 16-3 now. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
And he'll be out of bounds, just shy of the 30, right about the 29.
Yeah, let's get a sack lunch.
Mayfield off the play fake. Wide open. That's Clark. They lost him. A good pickup there, a 22.
Let's go, boys. Bring it up.
Play fake. Mayfield. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total.
I don't think my field goal kicker is good enough to do this.
To see about getting 3 points. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt.
Turnover. That's
we have
we
hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. There you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter, here we go. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for him. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The catch and run there, good for 16 in the first. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan. What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right? And chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense. And he still doesn't have a catch. We're into the second half. I think it's a little bit of a surprise to me, but that was one he should have caught.
Absolutely. That was his best opportunity right there. He dropped it. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards, the final tally.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Throw left side, complete to McLeod. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. And this offense on third down today, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 4. Out of the gun, it's White. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
Here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. The completion good for 3 and it's second down. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks.
Quit talking about it and bring it.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Throwing again on second down. White, that's complete right around the 8. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Let's go, baby.
Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll run for it with Smallwood. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Wendell Smallwood taking it in. And his guys are able to make this a close game again.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like...
Anybody here? Anyone?
Yeah, you know, you gotta feel right.
Anyone exactly. Here chatting to me?
And now trotting back out with the rest of his offensive mates.
I wonder who my one viewer is, probably me.
And some of his highlights here from this game, he's nearing 100 yards, Parker.
And defensive have worked so hard at how to try to slow down.
Mike, 40. 180! 40! Come on.
They'll run on first down. Elliott. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Another nice game, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line, and I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
Let's go.
Let's go. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. This, in all probability, another run here on 2nd and 8.
Watch the pass.
Well, the lead late in the fourth, but Mayfield's going to throw it. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's 3rd down.
Oh, boy, partner, did that just happen? I've got my hand over my eyes right now because, like him, it's going to haunt
me. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
You see me?
Now a second timeout called for by the defense. As they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on 4th down.
Let's go, D.
Now Mayfield on 4th down. And this is caught, pulled in by Clark. Now the defense will burn their 3rd and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down.
40's the mic. Let's get that ball right here.
On 1st down, it's Elliott. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Now that sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to 2nd down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
They go play action. Mayfield. Throw right side is going to be caught by Clark. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 16 yards, a 1st down. Well, a clear running situation. Try to take time off the clock. You ran the previous play. Set that play action up nicely.
Boy, did they ever, because they had shown the ability to run the football. So now you lose your keys as a defense. You dive for the running play, and they hit them over the top.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on foot.
And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Mayfield now. And he's got it. So the 2-point conversion is good, and they add on to the
score lead.
Target for the 2-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
Let's go, boy. Bring it up.
The situation for him offensively as follows. Down by 2 touchdowns. At time, a huge factor. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. White now on 1st and 10. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down. So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player? No chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Now White. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down.
Watch tight end.
So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
Here's
White throwing on 4th down. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Trevor Williams with a pick. And he's going to go down as time has now run out on this game. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And to be frank, Charles, probably not too many people surprised at how this one turned out.
Yeah, I don't think so at all. I mean, they're such a good football team. They were at home. You know, you walked in and you looked at the advantages and you saw that they had most of them. And take a
Ooh, 15,000. That's not bad. No, it's crap. All right, what time is it? 10:15. Let's go do the Larry Allen challenge. Can't see what that says. All right.
You saw the challenge on the screen. I don't need to repeat it. It's solo challenge. Madden Ultimate Team, go earn your keep. Mar now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. Leading them out is the Austin, Texas native at quarterback. It's Baker Mayfield. And now the offense getting set, first and 10. Here's the man who's led the league in rushing twice in three seasons, Ezekiel Elliott. Leighton Vander Esch, third in the NFL in tackles as a rookie last year, there on the stop.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play. And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. And he's got an open man, Clark. And out across midfield, down to the 45.
You ready? You ready?
They go for it on fourth down, and it pays off big time as they pick up 29.
Well, peel back the curtain, partner. We've got a pretty good look into how they plan to play this game. Aggressive seems to be the word. Going for it on fourth down in that situation.
Yeah, opening drive. Now, we know this coaching staff, they have traits of aggression in their history, but what a start to this game. They're going for it.
Yeah, a lot of people might say reckless, but they got it. One for one on fourth down here early in the game.
On second down there, it's Elliott. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 6 yards to pick up.
Feed Zeke.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback. And no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Elliott. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Come on now, let's go.
11 yards and a Cowboy first down. A gain of 11. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the open
drive. Hello, kitty. The ground game. Yeah, hello, kitty. Here's my kitty. Look, kitty's on webcam. Look, kitty's on famous. Hi, famous kitty. Hi, famous kitty. Playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish. Storm Janak on Instagram. You can follow her on the Instagram.
They'll run on first down. Elliott. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Same exact result as last play, a pickup of 11. The impressive opening drive continues, and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line, as this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. You mentioned very early on the need to establish a running game for this young QB. They really haven't been able to do that, though, in the first half.
So that means what in halftime? Adjustments, adjustments. Time, right? Figure out what they are. Figure out the things that they really want to accomplish and who to run behind. Which are your better blockers? Find those guys and get in that direction.
That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. That'll be third down.
Pass complete, but no gain.
You file that as unsuccessful.
Yeah, you do, don't you? Except on the stats, throwing the ball.
Get a completion.
You get a catch.
Yeah.
But still,
no yardage.
Okay.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime
report. Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, and you not get too many attempts shorter than that one. I don't think anyone got a finger on it. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
Prescott looks to throw on first. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Elliott. A loss of two there. Second down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized.
This is really hard to tell.
And you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to look good and look great in film. Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them, ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Now the Cowboys gonna burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. Now Cobb to return. A 46-yard boot, but just 36 following a pretty decent return of 10 yards. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Defensively,
if it was accurate, why didn't he catch it?
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Looking for Clark. He's got him complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Right side, that's complete to Clark. And he's out of bounds. Oh, almost gets to the 10. Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth cap.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Again, Elliott. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. They come out with one back and three tight ends. They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get 3 to end the first half. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalposts. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. Now, the drive ends in just 3, but they'll take it. Looks like they'll head to the locker room, barring something unfortunate, in front on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they may not be jumping up and down and celebrating because they have the lead, but still, any little momentum in a game like this is important to a team, and they'll feel real good about going in and regrouping, knowing that they are out in front.
And just like that, on we head to half number 2. These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape
on,
as they
baby.
Get up past the 30. Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter.
And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive.
Wow, mid-blitz, and he just blows me up the middle.
They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as
well. Oh, my God.
Headed towards the ball carrier with a
bandit. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
Tighten up.
I like watching the wide receiver.
That was horrendous.
Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen?
That, makes that could have been a sack.
Nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
But now a throw on first.
That should have been a sack.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. How about the defensive effort from both of these teams that we've seen in this game?
Would you say it's like a high-stakes chess match right now?
Chess is one way to go.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, the only reason I say that, you feel like they're contemplating their moves before actually making one.
The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense,
let's go, boys,
don't give
bring
up
it
any
up.
Points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
10th carry now for Alia. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
Xavier Woods on the tackle. It's a gain of 10. And the Cowboys first down. That's the end of the third quarter.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. On first down, it's Elliott. Tyrone Crawford in on the tackle. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock. That was an okay hookup there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
And quickly to his tight end, Clark. That's caught. That he's brought down short. 2 yards.
Are you effing kidding me?
2 yards is all again the completion. It's fourth down.
I don't think I can kick a 43-yard field goal.
It's understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Leighton Vander Esch wreaking havoc with a sack. You talk about not playing it safe. Why were they going for it there, Charles?
It's got to be a full evaluation of their team. Do they trust their defense in this situation? Maybe they think they've given all they can in this game and they don't have anything left. Do they not trust that the other team's quarterback is just so hot that it, no matter where they get the ball, they go downfield? Remember when Bill Belichick went for it in that game, right, against Indianapolis on the road, and everybody said, why'd you go for it there?
Here we go.
I think he just thought to himself, on the other side, if they hit the ball, they're going downfield anyway. He was trying to end the game right there with his own offense.
So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive.
Oh, my God.
And finally taken down at the 20-yard line. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. They'll look to throw.
They're still looking for their first touchdown of the game, and for a second, I thought they had it right there.
Looking on the sideline, it's finally good to see nods of approval. It's a welcome sign of life that this offense needed. Last year, Dak Prescott had 3 fourth-quarter comebacks, and he's in search of another one right now. He'll look to throw. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to come up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. This is Elliott, and he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. Mayfield to throw it. This complete again to Clark. He's been a busy man.
Good work, boys. Let's go. Let's go.
Absolutely ideal there. Get a good size play. Get out of bounds.
Well, you saw the coaching there. That is taught, and it is emphasized. Get out of bounds. Understand your situation as well as just understanding the game.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as he'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So from the 36 now, first and 10, here's Elliott. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe to get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college, and how about in the NFL? The miracle at the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee, and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time, ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Mike 54. Oh, you got deep?
So instead of running, Mayfield's going to throw it here. He'll find Clark open right side. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Mayfield on play action. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete. Chidobe Awuzie there to make the play and cover.
Chido!
Another shot from the nine on second and goal. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zeros.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And solid field position here to start as they get it out to the 40-yard line. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10.
Watch 82. He likes to sneak out late. Watch it quick.
One last shot now for Prescott. And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. So that does it. Put this one in the books. A successful Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. See you next time.
Thank you.
the challenge is in front of you. Do you accept it? I hope so. Keep the game on. Play the challenge. It's Solo Challenge, Madden Ultimate Team. And the offense readies for a first down and 10.
Edges, heavy on the edges.
Mayfield off the play fake. Wide open. That's Clark. They lost him. It's a gain of 16 and a Dallas first down. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting
under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Nick Vigil gets him for a loss of 10 yards from his linebacker spot. After the sack on first down, Mayfield rifles one into the hands of Clark. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A gain there of 21 yards.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than
anyone viewing.
10 years ago.
If you're here,
and I think it's because
say hello.
Glamour position because of the ways
love to know who's here.
And guys want to be involved.
Love to know how crappy I'm playing.
Line, close to the line of
scrimmage, I am.
Split out like receivers, but hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle. You put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards. This is caught, Clark. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line.
Hey, all
that'll
day,
bring
baby.
Up second and goal no after way. The gain of 5.
Now
timeout. Timeout called for by the offense.
Want a timeout? If you're here, say hello. I got a pass for 3 touchdowns, okay.
And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to 1 remaining.
I did. Anyone here? Say hello.
Crunch time, defense.
Mayfield with it once more. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown.
Touchdown!
Dallas Clark with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Still first quarter, 2 receiving touchdowns for him. How are they going to slow him down?
I think they're thinking about altering their game plan. Whatever they came in with, now maybe you switch a better cover guy to him. Or you make sure you have more people in his general area wherever he lines up. Try and discourage them from throwing the ball to him.
Here's Martin now following the score as he'll send this one away. And it's a short kick taken right around the 19. And a nifty return there as he's all the way up past the 40-yard line.
You're here, say hello.
Special teams, special
teams. Who's here.
The spark that often wins games.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? We'll see what they decide to do.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Tyler Boyd, the former Pitt Panther, was the target. And it's second down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route, for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. They go play action here on first down, and that'll wind up incomplete. Try to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. Green once again, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Passing again, Dalton on second and 10. And caught, right side, Green.
And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A.J. Green, 35
You know, just that in real life.
And the Bengals have got it back to a one-score game. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go. Uh-oh, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And here comes a big tight end as he gets set for this next drive. And we roll the highlights of the game he's had. You know, when we talk about wide receivers and how you shut them down.
Let's go, D. It's going to be a long day, offense. It's going to be a long day.
They go play action. Mayfield.
Oh, in the air. Are you effing kidding me?
Picked by Nick Vigil. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass. Well, tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do. In this case, that ball is expected to be caught.
This is Joe Mixon, fourth in the NFL in rushing last season. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. He'll get a nice jump there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Ready for the second quarter from Cincinnati. It's the Bengals with the football here. As they've got it with a second and four coming up.
Four down. Check, check.
On second down, here's Mixon. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run.
Go,
found
D.
His spot.
Here I come
picked
again.
Up nice yardage, didn't he?
Now he's got
here
him knocking
again.
On the door of the red zone.
Checking,
now Joe Mixon. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. It's a loss of two there, bringing out second down. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. He's got his man, Boyd. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Tyler Boyd, 28 yards. And the Bengals draw even, and of course they can take the lead if they hit the extra point. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
This will be fielded at the six.
Come on now, let's go!
Here's the Dallas offense now, heading back out onto the field.
Push him back. Push him back.
Play fake. Mayfield. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Ooh, Jedi Smash.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest.
I changed my Twitter to blue. Change the squirrely to blue.
They don't know the art of positioning.
Hey, Jedi Smash, how would I have two different scrollies?
In the right spot. Help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Another throw on second.
We have two of them.
This one incomplete as well. This drive, which was going so smooth.
Two different colors. Be kind of fun.
Two straight incompletion.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying... No more. We're speaking to stand right here, right now. But it is third and 10. They've got to get after him one more time.
And a nice gain of 21 yards. Now a play fake here on first down. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver?
So he's out of bounds.
Really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. 23 yards on the play. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up. And
that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Dallas Clark on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. Dallas Clark, boy, was he a red zone threat back in his day. 43 of his 53 touchdown catches came within the red zone.
You would think people would figure it out, right?
And he's going to go down just outside of the five, right around the six-yard line.
But I tried to get two and ended up getting none because the quarterback had nowhere to go with the ball and ends up getting sacked.
Nowhere to go at all. Great job, though, defensively. They were ready. And this is going to be stopped out. The Bengals recover. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team. That they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Throwing. Dalton brought in here by Tyler Eifert. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play? Made a nice catch and picked up a first down.
That's what impresses me about him. When he's called upon, usually gets it done. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
All right, that one fell incomplete there, but the best quarterbacks, they'll miss on 40% of their throws somewhere in that neighborhood, similar to a great hitter in baseball who's going to fail 7 out of 10 times and still have a great year. In this case, you want perfection, but way better that it hits the ground instead of going to an opposite color jersey. Martin, I think it's high time to give him some passes that he's comfortable with, some easy throws, some completions. He's not even hitting the 50% thus far.
Certainly that is play. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. And he's over with his third touchdown pass of the game. And the Bengals are going to jump back in front. Here's Bullock now for the extra point.
It's never any fun, Brandon, when you're the defensive team and the first drive of the game, you give up a touchdown. The key is not to get down. Make those adjustments and come back for your next series with the intent of shutting them down.
So that about as lengthy a drive as you're ever going to see. And it's finished off with a Cincinnati touchdown. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20.
80 yards, 68 minutes.
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face.
Come on, baby. Let's go.
Analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
No, check that. We're on Mike 52 right here. I'm coming, baby.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Throw right side is going to be caught by Clark. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run. Now, we know this offense has the potential to strike quickly, and they just bit off two huge plays on back-to-back snaps.
So on the other side of the ball, you've got to go Band of Brothers thought process. No one left behind. No pointing fingers, no accusations, because if you don't, those quick strikes we just saw, they become long-lasting.
23 yards, the final tally. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this
game,
he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down.
For who? For what?
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone.
Ready?
He's not hurried. He's not hit.
No, I suck. Nobody wants to watch me.
And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. On his way to a historic performance. Four first half touchdowns.
Create control report. Do I need to create an exception query?
Sure.
And do I need to update number solicited?
No.
So that's all I need to do, right?
Yep. Patrick, can we split my follow me on Twitter and follow me on Instagram into two, I mean Jedi Smash, into two different ones, different colors?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Wait, why do you have, what, you have my name on there?
What do you mean, do I have your name on there?
Why'd you say mine? There.
Not right now.
All right, so the challenge is laid out in front of you. Can you complete it? We're about to find out. Solo challenge, Madden Ultimate Team time. Let's go. And the offense gets set here for a third down play.
Let's go one more.
Play action, they'll throw. And he's got an open man, Clark. And he'll get this one way
Let's
up
go,
just
boy,
shy
bring
of
it
the 45-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay
screen,
off, don't they? What are the guys in the locker room
watch
calling?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him old reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get over. He finds a way to pick up a first down.
That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards.
40.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And again, he finds Clark. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Nice job. Congratulations to the Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. Your challenge awaits. Can you fulfill that solo challenge? Time to find out. It is indeed the solo challenge, and it's Madden Ultimate Team time. And on second down, the offense gets ready to rock.
Hey, D-line, let's get in there. Let's get in there, huh?
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Right side, that's complete to Clark. He's got this almost to the 40.
Here we go.
Before
Here we
going
go.
Out.
Here we go.
Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time down three scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their two-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
Well, unfortunately, unable to achieve the results you're looking for, but there's always next time. We'll see you. And now the offense getting ready on second down.
Mayfield on play action.
And a first hookup with his veteran tight end, Dallas Clark. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. Dallas Clark back in his day so good at catching red zone touchdown passes, but he's also very good in the middle of the field, anywhere on the field.
Absolutely fearless. Could absorb hits, absorb contact, not get knocked off of routes, and find a way to make catches and big plays to give them a big time advantage. Not bad for a former walk-on linebacker to the University of Iowa.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end, and he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Here I come.
And the tight end is certainly positioned to be able to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
And a good sign for them right now to have their young quarterback looking confident on the opening drive.
Now, we haven't met a young quarterback, a veteran quarterback. It doesn't matter. We haven't met a quarterback yet that doesn't tell us he's confident about his abilities, right?
That's true.
But when you're young, it's really important to get off to a good start because it does build up that confidence and allows them to play better as the game goes on.
Especially crucial here on the road.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Now left side, a completion to his tight end. That one, a first down pickup of 8. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has the feel of a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Script looks good so far. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. A 14-yard touchdown. And that does it for this Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. You did it. You defeated it. We'll see you next time. All right, it's Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. You know the drill. Let's get right down to it. You saw the challenge on the screen. I don't need to repeat it. It's Solo Challenge, Madden Ultimate Team. Go earn your keep.
Pass for how much? Oh, 65. Okay.
The offense for the Cowboys getting set to go on first and 10.
Get him! Get him! Get him!
Play action now. Here's Mayfield. Oh, he's able to outmuscle him here as he pulls it in.
Let's go, boy, let's go.
A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Mike 5-9, Mike 5-9.
Mayfield off the play fake.
You ain't doing nothing today.
He'll find Clark open right side. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Here we go, here we go.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. There's Clark. He's got him again. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Mayfield on first down.
Well, from an offense.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. All right, nice job. I believe that is challenge met and defeated from where I sit. Congratulations.
That's it. That's all I got. All right. Well, I'm done 2 hours. I guess that's it. I am going to log out.